Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are all safe and in very good spirits. Why I say good spirits? Because our today's discussion is on our spiritual vital force. So we are in this discussion, we are going to proceed from aphorism number 9 to aphorism number 18. Okay, so we go with the discussion first now from aphorism number 9. I have for your reference, I have quoted here the aphorism number 9. So just we will go through this aphorism. In the healthy condition of man, the spiritual vital force, the dynamis that animates the material body. Material body means our living organism, rules with unbounded sway and retains all the parts of the organism in admirable, harmonious of vital operation as regards both sensations and functions, so that our indwelling reason gifted mind can freely employ this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. So aphorism number 9, vital aphorism of Organon of Medicine, which describes vital force, that is the our most important aspect of homeopathy. The foundation of homeopathy is on the Dr. Hahnemann's discussion on the vital force, accepting as our life force, and everything is revolving around this. The phenomena of health, phenomena of disease, and then again cure, they are all revolving around the understanding of these spiritual vital force. Now, as we are in final year, I am not going to discuss the qualities of vital force, which you have already done in first year. So what is the important aspect of vital force with respect to understanding the concept of disease, that I would like to focus your attention on. So see the line which I have highlighted in the red color is this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. Now what is higher purpose of existence and what is the indwelling reason gifted mind? What is the importance of it? So our mind, the most highest gift from God to human beings is his possessed of the mind, and that is his intellect and then emotions. So the human being can think, he has memory, and how to utilize this for his one own self, for his family, for his society, for his nation and the whole world. So this is the importance, the extended understanding of the last two lines. How to use this living healthy instrument? So what is this instrument? This is nothing but the living organism. So man, he owns self for the higher purpose of existence, how he will perform himself. So what is most important is vital energy is possessed in all the living organisms, and this maintains health, harmony, equilibrium between the functioning of the various organs, and harmony between mind, body and soul. So the man with his possessed of this life energy, that is nothing but vital force, can enjoy the health, can enjoy the harmony between he oneself with his family, society and in the work area also. And also equilibrium is there between the functioning of various organs, because of which he will enjoy the state of health. Now, the survival of the fittest, what do you mean by this? This is Darwin's theory. So, a human being with his qualities of living energy, with his performance, and who will survive, who is fit in this all the adverse circumstances, and how he will remain fit by adaptation with the surroundings. So what is that which adapts to the surroundings? What is that which adapts? So what is that which adapts is nothing but your vital force. Now what is vital force? Nothing but life energy. So the last point in this aphorism number 9, I want to focus your attention, is service to humanity. Means what? The reason gifted mind, with your own intellect, with your emotions, with your mission, you should be able to serve the society. Service to the humanity. So we have our famous Baba Amte, who has served for the lepers. Mother Teresa, she was serving the beggars and those who did not have any home. So such a noble, famous personalities, they have served their entire life to the service of humanity, to the service of mankind. So ours is a again noble profession, and Dr. Hahnemann takes us from the journey from aphorism number 1 to aphorism number 9 now. So mission, cure, knowledge is, we will function as a prevention of disease, then to understand the causes of disease, and we have understood how to know the disease through totality of symptoms, and now the most important aspect of vital force. So our journey continues to understand the what is vital force. All of you are well aware of its qualities, so I don't want to go into that. We will see the further discussion on vital force. So the most important aspect that we should employ this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. We should dedicate ourselves for the service to humanity, service to the mankind, and that is the highest purpose of our existence. So we go further to the next slide. So this is a continuation for the aphorism number 9, that is our vital force. So what is I have done in the bold is the dynamis, spiritual vital force or life energy. So this is the gift of homeopathy to the all the patients and to actually to the field of medicine. Now what this is meaning to us, now let's concentrate and let's understand the application of this concept of dynamis, the dynamis, spiritual vital force or life energy. What is the application to the in the field of homeopathy? So what is, we just have a fast look, what is disease according to Dr. Hahnemann? What is disease? Affection of life energy is a disease. You must now by heart this all these concepts, that what is health? Health is a harmonious functioning of vital force, which we saw in this previous slide. So health is harmony, health is equilibrium. So vital force is harmoniously functioning, and equilibrium is maintained between the functioning of various organs, and patient or the person is at ease. Not patient, but the person is at ease. That is health. Now what is disease? It is affection of life energy is disease. Now we go further to understand if the disease is life energy, how this life energy gets affected by causes. So anything to affect the dynamic energy must be the dynamic causes. You understand the relation? If we consider health is a functioning of vital force, disease is affection of vital force, then how does this life energy or vital force is getting affected? Can anything material affect this life energy? You ask this question to yourself. Can anything material affect this life energy? How can it affect anything? If it is dynamic, it must be affected by dynamic causes. So see the second point, anything to affect dynamic energy must be dynamic causes. So homeopathy, we believe health is a functioning of vital force, disease is affection of vital force, and the causes of disease are dynamic in nature. So you should focus your attention on these three aspects. Health is also dynamic, disease is affection of this dynamic energy, and anything to affect dynamic energy must be the dynamic causes. Now see, we don't know how much quantity of bacteria has caused the disease. No researcher of modern medicine is able to tell us in any investigation that how much quantity of bacteria or virus parasite has caused the disease. Is it milligram? Is it say 100 grams? Is it some 1 kilo? So that idea is not there, because the quantity of this cannot be measured. Now we go to the last aspect. So cure of the disease is also must be by dynamic medicines. So our homeopathic medicines are dynamic medicines which are highly diluted and potentized. So not only they are diluted, but with the process of trituration or succussion, we are potentizing these medicines so that the latent curative power is aroused. So homeopathic medicines are not only the dilutions, but they are potentized, means the latent curative power is aroused. Okay, so I have spent the maximum time on this aphorism number 9, these two slides, very important. Now you have come to final year. What you must understand is the entire concept of health, disease, cure is revolving around this life energy. Now what is this life energy? If you can understand or easily accept the electrical energy, you can easily accept the magnetic energy, you are easily able to accept the gravitational energy. Now why we don't easily accept the presence of life energy? Biological science in one hand is accepting the presence of life energy, but they are not having any further elaboration of life energy. So life energy is just like the other magnetic energy, electrical energy, or gravitational energy. So the homeopathic concept of health, disease, cure, the causes of disease, and the cure by the medicines, all are dynamic in nature. So we go further. Now what is given in aphorism number 10 is absence of vital force. So absence of vital force is nothing but we call it as a death. So when there is no vital energy, there is no sensation, no function, no self-preservation, it's death or decay. So what is presence of vital energy? It means what? Vital energy imparts life to the organism. vital energy imparts life to the material organism. And without vital force, there is no sensation, no function, no self-preservation. It is death or decay. Thus, vital energy, all sensations and functions animates the material organism in health and disease. So, all the sensations and functions which we have is because of the presence of vital energy. So, we are surviving because of the presence of life energy. Once this life energy leaves the material organism, the person is dead. So, this life energy, it is very subtle in nature. What is subtle? Subtle in nature, it's very fine. It is of very primary nature. So we call it as dynamic nature. So we go to the further, to the next slide, that is aphorism number 11. Now we slowly progress further from aphorism number 11 to the understanding the causes of disease. Hahnemann is trying to make us understand what are the causes of disease believed in modern medicine and what are the causes of disease in homeopathy. So when we do the comparison of learning and understanding the causes of disease, we will understand what Hahnemann wants us to understand about the causes of disease in homeopathy. Okay, so we are going to learn two aspects in aphorism number 11, that is called as materia pecans, that is material cause of disease, and second aspect is dynamic influence, that is dynamic cause of the disease. Now, before I go with this slide discussion, I would like to tell you is that materia pecans means the material cause of the disease, which is believed in modern medicine. And dynamic influence is the dynamic cause of the disease, which is believed in homeopathy. Okay, so just be clear in the minds, materia pecans is the material cause. Now, what is material cause? For example, nothing but it is caused by, say, bacteria, say, viruses, so parasites. So, all these organs or the organisms are causing the disease. That is the concept in modern medicine, or Hahnemann calls it as old school. And dynamic cause of the disease, that is affection of vital force, is what we are believing in homeopathy. So we go with the slide discussion. So disease is dynamic derangement of spiritual vital force by morbific agents inimical to life. So what is disease? We already saw in the previous slide that disease is affection of vital force. So, how is the vital force? What are the qualities? You already know. It is dynamic in nature and spiritual in nature. So, disease is dynamic derangement of spiritual vital force caused by morbific agents, which are again dynamic in nature, and they are inimical, that is harmful to life. So this is called as the dynamic influence, means the dynamic cause, the dynamis. Hahnemann is giving lot of importance to make homeopaths understand the dynamic cause of the disease, which is called as dynamic influence. So we go further. Patient experiences in the state of disease nothing but disagreeable sensations and functions. Now, if we can easily understand the natural phenomena of tides, gravitational force, moon phases, magnetic energy, we should also be able to understand the concept of vital energy, which is not mechanical, not material, but dynamic in nature. So, dynamic action of disease producing agents is responsible for diseases. So I told you in the previous slide only we are discussing that Hale, I repeat for you to revise again and again, is that health is a due to the spiritual vital force. Disease is the affection of this spiritual vital force. Disease is caused by the dynamic causes, and cure is also by the administration of dynamic homeopathic medicines. Now, this dynamic action of medicines, we already know that we have done on provers, and then we can see the action, dynamic action of medicines on patients later on. So it is not the action of atoms, it is not material action. So action of dynamic energy hidden in medicinal substances acts on life energy of the patient. Very important statement. So where is this action of this potentized homeopathic medicines? On the life energy. So but in old school, that is in the modern medicine, they consider material cause of the disease and they deny the dynamic cause of the disease. So concept of vital force is supposed to be the most controversial concept, which is denied by the modern medicine in one hand, and they accept some part in at one time and they deny at another time. Okay, so now today's times of corona pandemic, we are Ayush department has given the arsenic ulp as a genus epidemicus for to be given as a preventive to all the population. So all the media and all the modern medicine doctors, they are asking, how is the action of this arsenic ulp? It is a poison. So what is the action of arsenic ulp? That though, although it is a poison, we are diluting it when we are doing coming to the 30th potency. So the dilution as well as potentization, we are able to liberate the hidden powers which are there in each and every medicinal substance. So it is enhanced. So dilution and enhancement of this hidden power, which is the beauty of homeopathic medicines. So I think I am clear that in aphorism number 11, we are understanding the cause of disease is dynamic in nature. So permanent in your minds. So causes of diseases are dynamic in nature is the concept we are holding in homeopathy, whereas the modern medicine considers the material cause of the disease. So we go further with the aphorism number 12. So what is discussed in aphorism number 12 is now cure. So we are progressing from health, disease. Causes of the diseases are dynamic, and the cure is also by dynamic medicines. So see what's there in this aphorism number 12. So what is cure? Now what happens? There is a change in the state of health to state of disease. Now we have to restore it back to the state of health. So see, morbidly deranged vital force produces morbid phenomena. Morbid means what? Diseased phenomena. It's outcome of internal derangement of this internal dynamics. So it is a derangement of vital force. Disease is nothing but derangement of vital force. Morbid alterations that differ from healthy vital operations. Now this disease we have to bring back to the state of health. This is called as cure. Cure is what? Restoration of the integrity of vital operations. Morbid phenomena, as we have discussed in the first three sentences, is disease. Now this is the disease is expressing through the signs and symptoms. We already saw it is totality of symptoms, and cure is removal of these symptoms. So cure is having the aspect that removal of these symptoms is cure. And how we are doing this? Go to the previous slide. The cure is possible by the action of dynamic energy which is hidden in the medicinal substances. So our homeopathic medicines are highly diluted and potentized, and they bring out the cure. Okay, so disease is the signs and symptoms, cure is removal of these signs and symptoms with the help of homeopathic medicines. See, now we go further with the aphorism number 13. I hope you all are with me in this discussion, because I already told you in the introduction lecture of aphorisms that what are aphorisms? They contain the truth, the truthful sentences which are filled with the scientific knowledge, and each next aphorism is always connected with the previous. So I want you all to be with me in this journey of understanding of aphorisms. So aphorism number 13 is nothing but again of materia pecans. Let's understand what is the concept of disease in the and the causes of disease in the modern medicine is nothing but materia pecans. I already told you in the previous slide, materia pecans is the material cause of the disease. So old school considers disease separate from vital force. They deny diseases in the interior of organism. So how much in depth the discussion is done? It is not just the material cause of the disease, but what is the concept of disease in the modern medicine, that is also Hahnemann is describing. So old school is considered disease is something separate from organs. Separate from vital force. And if you see the last two points, disease is in organs, disease is organ pathology, is the concept of old school. So old school considered disease is something separate from vital force, disease is in the organs, disease is the organ pathology. They deny the disease is subtle, they deny disease is dynamic. Whatever visible to eyes is disease. For them, whatever visible to the eyes is a disease. So warts is a disease, acne is a disease. So they will not consider why, what is that internal derangement which is responsible for this external pathology of say warts, acne. Very simple examples we have taken. Okay, so the modern medicine believes the material cause of the disease. And what is disease? For them, anything visible is a disease. So disease is in organs, disease is nothing but organ pathology. And what is the solution for this in the modern medicine? Is remove this organ pathology. That's the only solution. They will not pay a single attention that what has caused this disease in the organs. So what is that internal derangement in the organs? That is not at all considered in the modern medicine. So they are, their approach to treat disease is just superficial. Hence they are not paying any attention to the patient's symptoms. What they are paying attention is to the patient's signs. That the further discussion will be done subsequently. So aphorism number 13 tells us that the modern medicine believes on the material cause of the disease, and for them disease is nothing but organ pathology. Disease is in organs. Okay, so we move to the further aphorism number 14. Now, what are the curable indications in the disease? What are the curable indications in the disease? Curable indications of disease are the symptoms of the disease, are the symptoms which physician perceived through senses. Now, pay attention, dear students. Which symptoms are curable? So, which symptoms are curable? The curable indications of disease are the symptoms which physician has perceived through his senses. here, what is not mentioned in the aphorism or not written here is that physician has seen through the eyes. Those symptoms are not the curable indications. What he has perceived through senses means what? How he has done the case taking, how he has taken the patient's mental symptoms, how he has taken the patient's physical symptoms, especially physical generals. What are patient's cravings? What are patient's aversions? What is the thermal state of the patient? That physician himself is asking in his case taking. He is trying to build up the patient's mind, the mental picture of the symptoms. That's why Hahnemann writes that the curable indications are those which physician perceived through senses and not those which he has seen through eyes. So these symptoms, the mental generals and physical generals, they are highly important because they are the inner nature of man. And they are very near to the life principle. And I will add further, they are the individualizing features of the man. Which are the individualizing features? Mental generals and physical generals. They are very, very near to him. Suppose any person has craving 3 mark for sweets. When he sees the sweets, he is generating happiness. So that happiness, what he is feeling, that we can't understand. So that is the happiness is very near to himself. So all these mental general symptoms and physical general symptoms, they represent inner nature of man. They are very near to the life principle and they are the curable indications of disease. So any patient who comes with the any tumor, say or you can say the stones in the gallbladder, stones in the kidney, they are not the curable indications. Still you have to take the patient's case and you have to form the totality of symptoms and form the totality of symptoms which are given importance are the mental generals and physical generals, which will be the basis of prescription in homeopathy. Okay, and automatically when these symptoms are removed or they are these symptoms are considered highly given importance in the evaluation, the organ pathology will automatically regress. Okay, so we'll go further. Aphorism number 15. Symptoms are the mirror of disease. What is mentioned in this aphorism number 15? Symptoms are the mirror of disease. So organism is just material instrument of life energy. So body, what you see is the material aspect. You can feel the body parts, but you can't feel the mind. So life energy is reflected as mind, patient's intelligence. So organism is just material instrument. It is animated by vital energy. What is animation? Animation means to impart life. So, you know, the field of animation, the cartoons, where the pictures are drawn of the cartoons and because of the technology, you feel that these cartoons are live. So, this is animation, imparting life. So, vital energy imparts life to the material body. Vital force is not cognizable by the organism. Means what? Vital force is vital energy. It is not tangible, but its existence can be felt. Vital energy is like a dynamic energy, I mean the magnetic energy, gravitational energy. These energies are existing. They cannot be seen. So, it is not cognizable by the organism. Vital energy and body act as a unit. So, the symptoms are the mirror of disease. Means what? The disease will be expressed as the morbid symptoms, and symptoms means the disease. Disease is equal to symptoms, symptoms is equal to disease. Now again we go to the further analysis evaluation. In the symptoms we are again giving classifying the symptoms, which symptoms are important, like mental generals and physical generals we go give the highest importance, followed by physical particular symptoms. So this process of analysis and evaluation we do afterwards for the selection of the medicine. So before that we understand what are disease. Disease is expressed as symptoms. So we'll come to the further discussion that removal of symptoms is removal of disease. So we go to the next slide. Again a slight highlight is given on the aspect of health in the aphorism number 16. That is harmonious health is harmonious functioning of vital force. Equilibrium is maintained between the functioning of various organs, and the basically is harmony between mind, body and soul, and the functioning of various organs also. So person is feeling at ease, he is happy. So this is health. We go to the next. So in concern with this aphorism number 15, symptoms are the mirror of disease. So disease is equal to symptoms and symptoms is equal to disease. Now what is cure? Removal of symptoms is cure, that we see in this aphorism number 17. Removal of totality is removal of disease. So you follow this equation that disease is symptoms. So removal of totality of symptoms is removal of disease. Physician has to remove the symptoms. The internal disease is annihilated. Health is restored. This is the true mission of the physician. So true mission of the physician is what? That cure is nothing but removal of symptoms. And health is restored. So we go to the next, that is the I think last aphorism of today's discussion. Totality of symptoms is the sole guide for the selection of the simillimum. Now we have understood what is the phenomena of health, what is the phenomena of disease, and how cure takes place. So totality of symptoms is nothing but disease, and these will guide us for the selection of simillimum. I already told you that we are doing this process of analysis and evaluation for this purpose, selection of the simillimum. So disease is discovered by totality of symptoms. Some of symptoms in each case are the sole indications, sole guide to direct us for the choice of simillimum. So totality of symptoms is the sole guide for the selection of simillimum. Now simillimum we have already seen what will be the qualities of simillimum. I hope you are remembering simillimum in homeopathy is nothing but a highly diluted and potentized medicine. So this is highly diluted and potentized simillimum, so that the hidden qualities which are there, the hidden curative properties in that drug substance, they are enhanced. Thus it becomes a simillimum. So the it is already diluted, so any adverse effects of that drug substance in the crude form, we are able to remove it by the dilutions, and in the process of potentization, the hidden qualities are enhanced. The hidden curative qualities which are present are enhanced. So again it achieves the simillimum, again becomes a dynamic in nature. So you understand all these connections, the because of the functioning of vital force, the health is maintained, and these are various phenomena the person experiences in his life, that is state of health, state of disease, the disease is caused by the dynamic causes and also removed by dynamic medicines. So this completes the equation. So we stop here with this discussion from aphorism number 9 to 18. So I hope you have understood this, you have liked it, and any difficulties you have, you can tell me in the group or in my personal WhatsApp also. Okay, thank you.